Now, my version of fish and peas is slightly different. Taken from a French classic sauce au beurre, it's a mixture of peas and horseradish, but this one is pan-fried halibut with peas and horseradish with crispy pancetta bacon. Very simply, we've got our halibut here. Not the sort of things that you will buy from your local fishmonger, is it? But this is a small halibut, would you believe it? Small halibut. We can take a huge, there you go, huge big chopping board for this. Now what I'm going to do is actually show you how to fillet it. Now obviously you don't normally get fish like this, but it's quite nice to see it in its whole form. So taking your halibut, quite a large flat fish, there's four fillets to a halibut. One either side, and obviously as you turn it over, two underneath as well. You can see there we've got a huge piece. When you get on the head end, trim it round the top, insert your knife underneath. Again, just long strokes as well. Try not to be too bitty with the knife, otherwise it'll break up your fish too much. But nice long strokes with the knife, and your lovely fillet should just come straight off, which we've got there. You can always trim off the bones afterwards. You've got a lovely piece of halibut like that. Now, all I'd have to do is just repeat the process on the other side, and you would end up with another piece of halibut there, but I'm going to put that down to one side, keep my eye on it before the seagulls nick it. And then taking a knife, you can actually skin this, it's very straightforward to skin. What you do is just insert the knife at this end, pop your knife underneath, and then keeping the knife nice and flat on the actual chopping board, you don't actually move the knife, but you actually move the skin. And you wriggle the skin backwards and forwards, and as you're wriggling the skin backwards and forwards, if you've got a sharp knife, hopefully that'll come off like that. Tie a few of these together and you've got a jacket, or if you're Mr. Ward Thompson, you put that under the grill with a little bit of salt and charge people £7.50 for a salad. But a little bit of crispy skin. But got a nice little bit of halibut here. I was only joking about that, Anthony. Just take a nice halibut, cut this up into portions. Again, you can see how meaty the flesh of this halibut is. It's a beautiful, beautiful fish to cook with. It was once deemed quite expensive. A lot of restaurants tended to use it, but now a lot of bistros are using it. Even fish and chip shops actually sell halibut. It's really, really meaty style fish, but a delicious steak as well. So into our pan now, we can add a little bit of butter to cook this. Nice hot pan for this one. Touch of butter, touch of olive oil. Keep the heat nice and hot. Season up our fish. There we go. Some salt and pepper. Remember, not too much salt, because we're actually going to put pancetta in here, because it's quite salty anyway. And we can pop our fish, season it on both sides. Presentation side down first. So take whichever piece of side of the fillet you like most, which is this one, place it into our pan. There we go. We're just going to cook that now for about 2 minutes on one side, then turn it over 2 minutes on the other side. A piece of fish like that, about half an inch in thick, about 4 to 5 minutes, we'll cook it right the way through. I'll lose that to one side. Clean down my board here. Now, while that's cooking, I'm actually going to cook my pancetta at the same time. Now, over here is just a range of different types of pancetta that you can buy. If you can't find pancetta, use streaky bacon. But pancetta will come in sort of three forms, really. Nice thin slices, which we have here, which I'm going to use. Or it'll actually be the thicker slices. Now, the thicker slices will normally have the little rind on here. Now, pancetta is an Italian streaky bacon, that's what they use it for, but delicious, actually nice and crisp. You can't use it like our normal bacon, you wouldn't have it for breakfast, but great when you put it in dishes, particularly crisp on top of salads. And the final way to buy it is actually rolled, which we have here, which is a nice piece. They roll up in a little bit of string, cure it, and then thinly slice it, and you can pop these on salads as well. You can eat this raw, but what I'm going to do is actually just crisp this up with our halibut, so we can pop our slices in our pan and allow the flavours of this pancetta to ease out into our fish. So our fish is nearly cooked now. You can just turn this over before we take it out. Get this lovely colour. Not really like cod, it won't actually break up that much. A little bit forgiving. Take our halibut out now. Just leave that to rest slightly while we finish off cooking our pancetta and before we make our sauce. So So we're just going to take our lovely pancetta out now, so it's nice and crisp. There we go. We'll leave that on the side. And then in the same pan, we can actually make our sauce. Now I'm just going to run through the ingredients for our sauce, first of all, which we've got over here. A little bit of onions, some garlic, a touch of sugar, just to sweeten it up a little bit, some horseradish, some fresh garden peas, you can use frozen ones, which are fine, and then some little bit of lettuce, again, little gem lettuce are perfectly all right, a little bit of white wine, some lemon juice, and some double cream. So to make our sauce, we can take a touch of onion, or a little bit of shallot, nice and finely diced. Now into the same pan, have we cooked our fish, because we've got all the flavours from the bacon in there, we can pop our onion in, and our garlic, just to gradually start to sweat this down a bit. This is a little bit of chopped garlic, only wants about half a clove of garlic, go in there. Again, no need to add any more butter, because you've got all the nice fats from the bacon, or rather that pancetta in there. Soften that again, just a little bit. It's very, very quick and easy sauce this to make. Touch of sugar. You only want a little pinch of sugar. Just caramelise a little bit in our pan. Some horseradish, creamed horseradish for this, not the fresh stuff. Use the cream one, it's much easier to use. Touch of horseradish. Fry that all off. And before our onions and garlic colour too much, we can add a little bit of white wine. Just reduce that down a little bit before we add some double cream. Again, the reason why I'm using double cream, it doesn't split when it's boiled, especially when we add the lemon juice, otherwise it'll split straight away. We got a little bit more double cream, a touch more. Now while that's coming to the boil, we're just going to add just three more ingredients. These fresh peas, they can go into our pan. Good handful of fresh peas. Again, the frozen ones are perfectly all right. You can use them straight from the freezer. They can go in as well. Touch of our lettuce, this little gem lettuce, which can be sliced up. Now the French call this julienne, which is just a little bit of thin strips really, but just a little bit of lettuce, nice and finely sliced, into our pan as well. This is where we get the classic sauce au beurre combination, which is the lettuce and peas mixture. So we bring all this lot together. Some lemon juice. A good squeeze of lemon juice into our pan. Some salt. Remember the amount of salt that you put in here as well, because obviously we've got the pancetta, which is quite salty. And some freshly ground black pepper. So once it's come to the boil, just switch it off now. If you cook it any too longer than that, what happens is the lettuce starts to go brown and the dish doesn't look very nice and the lettuce becomes bitter. So leave it at that. Once it's come to the boil, turn off the heat. You can then take our spoon here, a lovely peas and lettuce combination. This nice green colour of the lettuce as well. There we go. Once you've got your sauce on the plate, take your lovely thick meaty chunk of halibut, that can sit on there, and all that's left to do is put the crispy pancetta around the edge. So there we have it, halibut with pancetta and peas.